YouTube, you beautiful fuckers.
How the hell are you?
I am TC.
And I'm Alex.
We are Tanner X. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to the channel if you're new around here, guys. And today we're bringing you day number two of post-human survival horror week from Bring Me the Horizon. Checking out their new released EP, short-length album. And if you missed it yesterday, we checked out Kingslayer featuring Baby Metal. And that song fucking rocked, kicked ass. If you've missed any of the other songs that we checked out from this new EP album thing, it'll be down in the description below on a playlist. But we're bringing you Dear Diary today. And if you missed yesterday's video, or if you checked it out, and we met a couple of, or she, Alex did, about it seeming like it came straight out of a video game. Mm-hmm. And so we're doing some looking around, digging for Dear Diary, and I found on Genius that the album Post-Human Survival Horror actually makes references to several video games. In Dear Diary, this song in particular, there are multiple allusions to the original Resident Evil. Most specifically, the song alludes to a diary entry found in the Spencer Mansion known as the Keeper's Diary. The book is notable for its intimate description of a T-virus infection written by a researcher undergoing the process. As the author succumbs to the infection, the last entry infamously reads, "Itchy, tasty."
Yep.
So, that's interesting. Like I said, kind of picking back off of yesterday, because it did, like, Kingslayer seemed like it was very much of a fighting a boss in a final battle of a video game. So, it's interesting to see that that's kind of what this album's based around. But, with that being said, enough of that. Let's get into Dear Diary, guys. If you like this video, slap that like button. If you like seeing this channel and you're around here, hit that subscribe button, notification bell right next to it so you're getting videos when they go live. Link to this video will be down in the description below. But, with that being said, without further ado, let's Dear Diary by Bring Me the Horizon. Let's go. Plague siren. Kind of looting spill. Oh my God, yes!
Oh! Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Dear diary, I feel it chill like there's bugs under my skin. The dog's gone rabid.
Shut the fuck up! Doing my head in. I keep fading in and out. I don't know where I've been, but I feel so hungry.
This is so refreshing and just,
Dear diary, don't stop barking, probably cause I ate his face.
Jesus.
Tasty, itchy TV say there's no more human race. Kinda sad, my whole entire existence being a waste. I never mind, it's not the end of the world. Oh, wait.
God damn, man. They just keep getting better. They just keep getting better.
I'm just saying, I know that you said it reminded you of Sepaternal in the last one.
But this
is way before that. I just...
This put me back in 2009, getting an Alex's Cutlass on the way to school, getting blasted out of the speakers at 6:30 in the morning, listening to Alligator Blood and Pray for Plagues. Like...
Yeah.
Oh my god, they just keep getting heavier and they keep getting better over the last 3-4 songs that we've checked out. And it's just... What kills me and what's so great is that, you know, Luden's kind of piggybacks off of, okay, we're getting back into Bring Me and we're kind of, you know, expanding on that Amos sound.
Yeah.
And then Parasite Eve kind of reached back a little bit into That's the Spirit. And then Kingslayer reached back into, or Teardrops, and Kingslayer kind of reached back into Simp Eternal. And then this was just like, we're putting everything we've ever known into a song and putting all the elements that we've worked on for so long and just creating a killer song. And I keep forgetting about Obey with Youngblood, but that's kind of in a league of its own, I think, with these other songs that we've checked out. And man, like, I don't know, I'm impressed. Like, that opening riff hit, and I was just so, like, surprised because that's not what I'm expecting by them. And I think that's what a lot of people... I'm sure are enjoying with this album. Yeah. And it's like, because this is the first song off the album, and that's what kicks it off. And I just think that leading a album off with that really, like, says, okay, so they're back on the map, and they have not abandoned that sound.
And something that just gets me, and I don't know if it's because we looked at Genius before we started, but, like, with all of the songs, just, like, without even the lyrics... But, like, the music itself gives you, like, this such a strong visual image. Like, it started, and I could see someone running through fucking Zombieland, New York. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then, of course, they come in with the lyrics that are just, like, punch you in the fucking face because they've always been like that. They don't hold back.
No.
And it was just...
Ollie is very honest, and he does a really good job at writing lyrics and things like that. And, you know, like I said in... Kingslayer, it's just crazy because, like, these are some of the most intense drums that I can ever remember and Bring Me songs, and the guitar riffs and the electronics mixed in, like, it's just all so...
The guitar riffs in this one seem to hit me harder than the drums did for this song in particular. Like, halfway through, I was like, damn!
Yeah, and it's just...
damn!
I don't know, like, I'm so excited to check out what's next on this album, guys. Make sure you come back tomorrow for that. I don't know which one we're going to check out yet, but there's another one coming tomorrow, there's another one coming Thursday, and then we're ending on Amy Lee's feature on Friday, so make sure you come back for that. If you're not subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you are here when those videos go live. But with that being said, do you have anything else you want to add?
No.
I am TC.
No,
we're TNRX. Keep that head up. Life is so fucking beautiful. Until next time.
Peace.
Adios. Deuces.